Hello chess friends, today we're gonna talk about bishop strategy. Bishop is strong if the position was open, and there are many long diagonals for the bishop. And most of the diagonal, the outpost of bishop is in the flank, like b2 and a3, or e2 then b1. Also a1, and this position, this is white to play. And how to improve our bishop, or we need to see or lock our bishop if the bishop was have a purpose to that square, like bishop on e3, no purpose, like controlling the e3 or to e7, but has a pawn on c5, b16, e7. We will improve our bishop to bishop c1, then bishop b2. White played here bishop b3, and then bishop c1, then bishop b2. And prefers to transfer to the dark square. Rook fd8. Bishop c1, queen f8, bishop b2, controlling the long diagonal, h6, king g2, improving the king, and the idea on rook h1, then h4, h5, knight g8, preparing to maneuver the knight. d7, then knight c6, knight e5, seizing the pairs of bishop, because pairs of bishop is strong, like because it's like a sniper. Bishop takes e5, bishop takes e5, knight e7. Preparing to knight c6 and followed by e5, d4, bishop b5, knight d5. If you see why white can't capture the knight, because black pin the queen. Queen c1, good move. White notice has that is worth the exchange to launch a strong attack, much less as promised on rook e1. Knight e3, queen takes e3, rook takes d1, rook takes d1, rook takes d1. White sacrifice a material hull to attack the king side and to put pressure on the king side. Into compensation, queen takes h6. Black can capture the queen easily because of queen and king on h6. Bishop h7, and bishop c4. The other bishop joins in the black king side and help the king side attack. Queen f7, bishop takes c6, queen g6, queen f4, rook d8, queen f7, and black resigned here because if one square to move the king, queen c6, then queen g5, a mate to the g7 pawn. And preventing mate can prevent but a lost material. And if black played here rook d7, rook d2, check, then king h3, a simple king h3, then white wins here. And the second example which is also white to play, and our bishop on d2 has a passive. And white played here bishop c1 to put the bishop on a3, then to control the long diagonal on a3 to f8. Then g6, preparing to knight h7 in order to swap the good the bad knight on f8 to a good knight on g4. White played here bishop a3. h7, knight f3, good move. Don't exchange your good knight to a bad knight on h7. And a logical retreat by a knight. Queen d8. King d7. Rook fb8. Knight f5. Controlling some square on king side. Bishop c5, moving forward your piece, because chess is moving forward. It's also backward with a purpose, like a battle on controlling squares or space advantage. Kc6, in order to construct some kind of fortress on queen side. Queen c1, good move. It is the queen turn to exploit the a3 and f8 diagonal. Rook g8, like a passive or blunder move. Perhaps black was expecting the natural queen a3. Black is expecting here natural queen a3. But white has much stronger option, like rook takes a4. Sacrifice, b takes e4, queen a3, queen a5, bishop takes f5. If black played here, g takes f5, then white played here, bishop d6, bishop e7, I mean, bishop e7, to put the queen on d6, a mate to the king. Rook gb8, rook takes gb8, rook takes gb8, bishop h3, and white is win a material. And this is black to play. The main focus on the bishop is bishop g7. b7, but if you put the bishop on g7, it's a passive because of a blocking pawn on e5 and c3. Then a good move here is bishop e7 to control the b6 and g1 diagonal. Knight fd1, knight 1 d1, d2, bishop d8, preparing to bishop b6, king g1, bishop b6, queen e2, of course, because bishop is threatening to the major piece, king g7. In such a superior position, black has time for a few moves, useful moves. Knight h4, preparing knight g to maneuver the knight to knight g2, then push pawn, breaking pawn on b4, queen d8, knight g2, knight g5. Before white plays here h3 or h4. If h4, then if h4 here, then knight h3 check and take the pawn on f2. like in h2, knight f6, increase the pressure on e4. If knight takes knight, knight f6, increase the pressure on e4. Knight f3, knight takes e4, bishop takes e4, knight takes e4, knight takes e5, bishop a8, of course, because knight took the bishop, hanging bishop. Black maintains the strong bishop, thus creating several strong threats, such as bishop takes f2, rook e7, and rook a2, rook e7. Get a pawn before getting a piece, losing a piece. F takes g6, f takes e4, rook takes e4, take the queen. Queen c2, rook takes e1, knight takes e1, h4, a finally power move that leaves the white king without shelter. Bishop c1, queen d5, to a mate on h1, knight g2, h takes g3, I will move for black. If king takes g3 here, then queen f3, king h2, bishop f2 to not protect his knight, to threatening mate on g2. If black did not capture the pawn, then bishop f2, same ideas to mate on g2. In this position, this is also white to play. There are many options how to improve our bishop. This theme is how to improve our bishop and also bishop strategies. There are 5 options to improve our bishop. Bishop d2, bishop e3, bishop f4, bishop g4, and b3, then bishop e2. If you wondered why I put red on this squares, because that is like not a strong idea or squares for the bishop. Strong squares of the bishop is b3, is b2, to control the long diagonal. There are two main diagonal on bishop, the a1 to h8 and h1 to a8. Then I played here b3, rook fe8, a basic principle to put our rook on semi-open file. On semi-open file because on pawn locking the file. Bishop b2, bishop f8, a threatening mate on g7, and ad1, it's controlling the semi-open file, and also white slowly reinforces his position, aware that the opponent can't undertake any active measures. Queen c6, rook fe1, e6, preventing the maybe preventing the b5, f3, the idea on g4, you can king h1, then rook g1, rook ad8, controlling the semi-open file, king h8, queen d7, knight e2, to put the knight on c4, then control the h5, because The idea on g4 is to trap the knight. Rook d6. Black protecting the or preparing to control the knight at the 6th rank and to challenge the rook on g5, but it's a lost tempo for black because of a knight f4, rook ee8, g4 trapping the knight, h6, then rook d1. Few moves later, white is wins here. And preparing to g, the young rook g1 is preparing to g4, g5 with strong attack. Evidently, the bishop is well placed for this purpose on b2. Bishop outpost on b2. Not surprisingly, there are an entire opening system based on the deployment of bishop on the long diagonal, like Larsen, Bird, Rayati opening, Catalan, and DC. And this last example that I show you, this is block to play. And this is also bishop strategies, and this is equal. To press bishop of white and to press bishop of white, but the difference here is the black is the white king is uncastled, is in black never castled, and black can castle. Black played here b6 to control the main diagonal of the light square bishop, c3, provoking the knight on to restrict the knight on d4 or knight b4, bishop a6, controlling the diagonal on a6 or to f1. Bishop f1 challenging the bishop, castling, check the rook, don't block and take the bishop. It's legal. Let me d2, king c2, bishop d3. Bishop d3, then h6, no, knight f6, king c2, knight f6, bishop d3, h6, preventing the knight on g4 and more and give pressure on f7, making the rook. Rook e1. g5, good move to put the bishop on g7, then controlling a long diagonal. Black continues active play. H3, g4, also the idea of g4, knight g4. Knight is g4, rook f1, knight on f2 pawn, and this is a strong knight because this is outpost, temporary outpost because have a pawn on f2, preventing the knight. H5, black hurries to open up the h-file before white's queenside pieces get into play. a4, knight ce5, knight takes e5, knight takes e5, Bishop e2, h4, g4, of course, because don't the pawn to active the rook, one of the theory, h3, f3, h2, then h1. Intending to bishop h6, maybe busting. Bishop h6, then bishop f4. Busting pressure on white camp, black soon won. And a few moves later, black can win here. This is winning for black. And if you learned to my video, please subscribe and click the notification below so that you can update to my next video. Thank you.